Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to create offset copies of an open path, such as this one, a freeform path. So we're going to create parallel running paths to this. And first of all, I'm going to use a plugin. So I'm going to use Astute Graphics plugins, and you find that one under the stylism tool in AG Offset. It opens a panel. There you can input your options and set the distance and number of steps exactly. And you see this is how it would look like. But you can also just click and drag and then use the up and down arrow key and adjust this intuitively, like so. And you can also make this go both sides, like so. And this is nice because it's an effect. So when you go to Window Appearance, then you see there it is, AG Offset. And you can turn it off and on, and you can go into the options and change them, which is nice. If you actually want to have the paths, then you have to go to Object and then Expand Appearance, so you get actual path. I'm going to leave this because we are going to take a look at this again later on. So let's take a look at the native methods. Let's go to Object, Path, Offset Path, because with that you can do it as well. This makes a copy and expands that and then has it selected, like so. So there is the original one and there's the offset one, which is selected. And as long as it's selected, you can then go to Object, Path, Offset Path again, and there it is. The downside of this is the first one is okay, but then it will get a longer path because it always creates this overshoot. Now you would need to delete that later on. The next method would be kind of the same, but you could use Window Appearance and then apply a set of strokes. So let's make another stroke, and I'm going to make this one thicker and another color, like so. And then you make a series of strokes, and each one is thicker than the last one. And let's make this one in yellow so you see how this works. I'm going to first make a copy of this and delete the appearance of that copy so we can use that one later on, because there's another method. And to actually get these strokes, what you can do is go to Object, Expand Appearance, and then Object, and let's ungroup this first and select them all but the black one. So the black one is hopefully not selected. Let's check that out in the Layers panel. Yes. There's only the red and the yellow selected, and then you could go to Object, Path, and Outline Stroke. And then you would have your copies. So that would be kind of tedious, but works. Let's take a look at the next method, and that one would use a brush. Let's first create that brush, and I'm going to use, of course, black strokes for that. So you would need to decide about the number of parallel lines you want first, and then go to the brushes panel and drag them in here and make an art brush, like so. The lines have not been outlined, so these are live strokes in there, which makes this kind of nice. Like so, and then you can select the line and apply these, like so. Okay, those are your methods. Now let's take a look at what you can do with them. I can delete that. Okay. So when using this method with that brush, what you could do is apply a width profile to it and get this kind of thing. Or take a different profile and create it like so. That works because these are still open paths, not outlined. What you can also apply to that, and I'm going to reset that to uniform, you can use effects on it. So let's go to Effect, Distort and Transform, and roughen that slightly. So this is nice and funky, but not what I wanted to show. So take a look at it. What this does is it first roughens the path and then applies the brush. If you take that and drag it down here, then the brush gets applied first and then you roughen it and get these nice lines. We can make that detail slightly smaller and then make it smooth. And also make the size smaller and you get these nice lines. Like so. Scribbled lines. Maybe you need that sometime. This also works on the plugin. So if you get the roughen effect, like so, and you see this time it's applied before AG offset, and you see that creates this kind of thing. So let's go in here and make the size larger and the detail smaller, and you see what this does. So the roughened parts get then offset, which creates this shape. You can also apply roughen after the offset, and then you get something similar to the brush created thing, like so. Of course, you can apply effects to this as well, because these are paths, so that works. So, several methods of creating parallel strokes, and there you can choose the way you want to go.